This is someone we actually... the stream went down right while I was talking to you. So this bodes well. I finally got my dream girl. You don't understand how long I've dreamt of this. Get it? Dream? Dreamcast? Man, I don't know. My 1,000-year crush might be fading. Also, it's kind of unfortunately rare that they actually properly acknowledge lesbianism in even these games, which are like super mega lesbian, which they should really embrace more. It kind of sucks that they are so... they always shy away from it. Was that the mission? That was the mission. Okay, there's actually some story missions. Oh, hey, we can weaken enemies now. I shouldn't really need it, though. Some of the story missions really are just a cutscene, and then you go, you know, you can get a new one. Let's go pester Dreamcast. What level am I again? I'm about 30? I think I should be fine for almost any story event. There's... I think the hardest one is Saturn? And I think I recommend being around 45 there. So I think I can finish up everything but Sega Saturn, then go back. Now let's go. Also, this is a new map, I think, as far as the stream is concerned. I've seen it before, of course, but, well, new as in new in this game. It's, you know, it's Planet Neptune from, Victory. Been reused a few times. Oddly, we see two... Actually, maybe we only see one version of it. But this is not one of the ones that changes as time goes on, unfortunately. I really wish they made sure every one of the maps did a nice little change. Also, let's go find that baseball before I forget about it. I really do like that the baseball gives you a good reason to explore the stage and everything. And so does the treasure. I mean, I always explored for treasure anyway, because, I mean, there's always some manner of treasure in the games. Don't you drop those frames! You gotta be kidding me. I'm being throttled. It has to be being throttled. What is... Hold on. I'm not even streaming at... my full bitrate, and I'm dropping frames. It has to be my stupid internet service provider. It has to be. It was saying 14 megabits up was working. Okay, it's not dropping frames anymore, but how awful does this look? I had to cut... this is like less than half of what my quality usually looks like. Let's see what it looks like in motion. Looks bad, and that's still dropping frames, at least on Beam. It's just a badness. Well, I guess I can turn it down to oh god, that's awful. What is wrong with this? Oh my god, I'm so pissed. Cut the frame rate down without killing the stream. Don't think I can. No. Ugh. Let's see if... maybe if I turn this to 30, it'll work? How is it? God damn it, Twitch, are you not working at all?
How long do I have to wait?
Twitch, what is wrong with you? don't think Twitch is getting it at all. Oh. It's working after a refresh. I guess that doesn't look horrible? Maybe? Ugh, this is so fucking stupid. I hate my internet service provider. I hate them. It's Mediacom. They're freaking terrible. They're awful and I hate them. And I don't have any other choice. They are the only internet, they are the only cable provider in this area. I literally can't choose anything aside from them, satellite, or DSL.
All better now. Thank you. It's no trouble at all. Take care of yourself, okay? Okay, I will. Bye. Okay, so who's next? Huh?
Dreamcast? What are you doing here?
Oh, hi, Segami. Isn't it obvious?
You don't have.
Why is the color wrong on frickin' Twitch?
I don't know if she's gonna be able to answer that, Nep. This is getting weird. What were you really doing?
I was fixing my hardware. It's been a little while since the release, and a handful of people have been having problems.
Isn't that pretty hard work?
No, not really. We only sold a few units.
Oh, I see.
That's kind of embarrassing.
No, it's not. There aren't as many people living in this era. Of course she wouldn't have shipped as many. Right? That's it, right?
Yes, that's exactly right.
Poor Dreamcast.
It's a solid console. I think if this was a less turbulent era, it would have definitely sold more. Seriously, it was just bad timing.
I see.
I'm pretty sure I can hear the sound of Dreamcast's heart breaking.
In any case, it is impressive that she fixes the issues herself. That's so cool. Why don't you do that, Nep?
I will consider it. As she shifts her headlights. Why are you all here, though? Were you able to talk to Uzume?
Yeah. I made her promise me that she wouldn't fight you anymore.
Are you serious? She's got an appetite for destruction. I don't believe you at all.
Oh, calm down. She really said it. She couldn't fight if she wanted to. She's recovering from your last bout.
I see. Well, I guess I can focus on my actual job for a little while. When I get sucked into these battles, I have to neglect what I'm here for.
For a second there, I thought you weren't gonna believe us.
You just don't know Uzume like I do. She's relentless. Her resolve to take me down is almost admirable.
Ah, that's my Uzume. Even her enemies respect her.
I mean, she's also very dumb and crass and irreverent. And I really don't know what to do about her.
How impressive.
Ah, yes. Classic Uzume.
Maybe Uzume and I will have our final battle after she recovers.
Why are you still talking about fighting? You promised you wouldn't fight.
All I said was that I wouldn't fight for a while. If Uzume tries to push me around, I'm not backing down. This world has had enough of these endless battles.
But you can't blame that all on Uzume.
If you insist on stopping that, I'll be forced to fight you once again. You might not be so lucky next time.
You don't have to glare at us like that. I just... We're done here, Segami. We're in the middle of some sightseeing, so we'll be leaving now.
Oh, you were sightseeing, huh?
Hey, let go! I have so much to say! Nep, let's roll.
Alrighty. Hey! What was that all about?
It's kind of funny how all of the characters being massive jerks kind of totally fits with Sega's whole deal. Hey, Black Knight. I don't know what Twitch's frickin' problem is over here. Its colors are all wrong. Let me try something. Guess we don't need 60 FPS on this game. I hate how this stream looks, but I guess I can just upload the better my local recording. Yeah, that didn't fix it at all. Did it? I can't tell. Let me go to a place again. I don't think the colors are fixed. Let's look at a skin tone here. Come on, Twitch. Yeah, Twitch is really blown out. I don't know what it's doing. It looks like an Xbox One game. Which I'm amazed they still haven't fixed. Does the Xbox One S fix their color issue? I think it's a little different. Twitch is just gonna look a little worse. That's fine. Whatever. Wait, hold on. I'm gonna test my upload speed here. Because either... I'm pretty sure my frickin' cable company is throttling me. I got 14 megabits up before this. What the hell? I'm getting 14 up, but the stream isn't working. And every time I try to stream, it stops working. I can stream 1 megabit per second up, but let's go up to 1.5. And I bet we'll start immediately dropping frames. Alright, maybe not immediately, but I don't know. Maybe it's fixed now. It's probably not. Let's talk to these people. I was having a great day until I started trying to stream and then internet issues happened. Anyway, Feudal Lord. Well, they ruined some of the names of these people. Like, this used to be the king of some cosmos. Some of these Chirper characters' names are really lame now. I don't get it. I mean, this is obviously the king of all cosmos from Katamari. And the name used to be a pretty direct reference to that, and now it's like, Feudal Lord? What? Anyway, the competitive game market means more publishing trying to outdo each other. Loading time takes longer because of that. It irritates me that I have to wait every time to go into battle. We need a load time revolution. Indeed. Alright, we're not dropping frames yet. I hate this. I hate streaming. Sometimes. I hate the technical aspects of it. Anyway. The young praise me. The veterans look down on me. Being an intermediate level adventurer isn't easy. I don't know, lots of games are most fun in the intermediate stages, though. Because, like, there's nothing to do at max level, and there's nothing to do, like, except tutorials at the start, so... Sometimes that's the best part. Okay, it seems to be stabilizing. Let me see how it looks on beam. Beep! Beep! Yes, yes, you're beeping, I know. Ah, I'm hungry, feed me something! Yes, she has battery issues. It's like you have problems when you show up. Nah, it's just... I'm pretty sure it's either my internet, or maybe... No, it can't be restreamed, because it happened when I went direct to beam, too. It's... Okay. I'm gonna go all the way up to 2 megabits per second, which is less than a fifth of what I'm paying for, by the way. And we're gonna see if I drop frames again. I hate this. I want to be talking about the game, not this stupid internet... You know, connection crap. I can't believe, you know, this is the United States. We invented the internet. Well, how can we have all of this bullshit? Ugh. Damn it. So anyway, we lost, once again, you know, a bit of time got eaten, so we, the boss is still gonna be hard. So there's two... Basically, there's two ways to beat the Time Eater. One, if you do all of the quests, it'll be a lot easier. You know, that's the Chrono Trigger way of, like... You know, if you fight Lavos the story way, he's a lot weaker. That's basically what we got going on here. I'm not dropping frames. It fixed itself? I don't... Whatever. I'll... Just let me know if things get shitty. But I guess for now, maybe it's fixed? I don't know. I yelled at Mediacom on Twitter. Maybe they just decided to stop the, you know, turn off the harass tap tap button. Wait. Alright. You have to go out and back in. It's so weird. It doesn't matter too much, but it's like, why? Oh, hey, it's R4. Oh. Let's check up on Uzume. I think we do fight somebody again in this era. But it's been oddly peaceful. Aw, you're creepy. Veteran creator. I don't know who this guy's supposed to be a reference to, but I don't like him. Funny, seems like the traffic problems are resolved. I won't have to take the scenic route to work anymore. Aw, man. I've been having so much traffic on my route to work. The bridge that I take to work is going to be torn down in a few years. So they've been rerouting. Wait. I'm in here? Okay. I forgot this was involved in the main story because it's like such an optional location in the other eras. But yeah, so my route to work usually takes 10 to 15 minutes. It was over a half an hour during construction.
Here, huh? How are you feeling? Ugh, you again. Hey, come on. We came all the way out here to see how you were doing.
I never asked you to check up on me.
I'm actually here to make sure you're still injured and in pain.
Right, much better, asshole.
After you get healed up. Oh, hey.
I don't get how people can't like Sega.
I have a great idea to keep you and Dreamcast from fighting.
This can't be good.
Look at her.
But I know you're just gonna tell us anyway.
As long as she never recovers, the two of them won't battle, right?
Calm down.
What? What are you saying? I knew it.
Segami, you're insane.
Look who's talking.
What? Is it really that bad of an idea?
Maybe.
What am I saying? I'm sorry. Forget I said anything.
I can still see it in your eyes.
Sorry, Uzume. This one has a tendency to go a little overboard sometimes.
Sure. I don't get this at all, but whatever.
Hmm?
And why am I talking so casually with a bike?
Ah, so it does weird you out a little bit. That's good. At least now I know you're slightly normal.
Oh, I haven't introduced myself, have I? I'm Neptune. I'm a bike right now. But my true identity is...
Whatever. I'm calling you Bikesy.
Hey, Bikesy. You just skipped my dialogue. And Bikesy? Is that the best you got?
Your name is so hard to say. How about Bike Neps?
No, Bikesy. One thing I don't like in these sort of dialogue systems is that if you auto advance, even when you know, even when auto advance is on, when somebody's like being cut off, there's still that awkward pause. Like, it doesn't flow quite naturally.
I love Smokey too much to allow myself to be called that.
Smokey.
Smokey?
Exactly.
Maybe I should cut my losses and let Nep get stolen by Debo before the game is over. You two are freaking crazy. I like you, Nepsy.
Hey, I like you too, Uzume. Wow, maybe we're soulmates.
So if you're friends now, does that mean you'll do her a favor and not fight with Dreamcast anymore?
What? Why not? My bouts with Dreamcast have nothing to do with Nepsy.
Yeah, I guess.
Aw, come on, Bikesy.
You're striking out today.
Of course I do.
Hey, Uzume, as a sign of our friendship, do you want to ride me?
Phrasing?
I'm not one to brag, but I'll give you the most comfortable and thrilling ride you've ever had.
Phrasing!
I'll have to take you up on your offer as soon as I defeat Dreamcast. I need to make the world peaceful again.
Are we not doing phrasing anymore?
There we go. There's our flag.
Uzume's death flag, huh? That's not good. We've got to stop them. If only we had a good idea for that.
Just give it up already.
Seems like they would only need to resolve the beef in the earliest timeline. It would make sense, but it's like... they're sort of interconnected, like... I guess history has been eaten at separate areas, and we gotta restore them separately. Whatever. It wouldn't be any fun if we didn't get to visit all the different areas. To have online functionality in games, like it's such a normal thing. I'm sure people in the past would have never imagined it possible. It wasn't exactly a normal thing on Dreamcast either, but... I did download on my Dreamcast, I had a Dreamcast, and... I downloaded some, like, fruits and stuff from the Sonic Adventure 2 thing. I never had Phantasy Star Online, unfortunately. I actually did not know many of the Dreamcast's good games. I honestly, like, Sega was basically Sonic, and maybe some random stuff I found in a magazine.
Hi, Parker. Yes, hello.
I'm being forced. They won't let me stop talking. Same! Hurry up and close the speech bubble so I can leave! I like this guy. Alrighty, let's see what our class levels are. We get... Oh. Our original cap is 20. So, ideally, we want to get second classes before everyone hits level 20, but it's probably not going to happen. Because we have to complete storylines in order to unlock the second class. Uzume heads to battle. That's right, Parker. Would you calm down? My cat decided to visit. Back to here.
Target location down.
Still back in the back? Yes, you are. Why is she? Well, whatever. This set of points to make me walk over here.
Awesome. I don't feel the pain anymore. My body feels a little stiff, though. I could use some training.
Uh-oh.
Actually, I think I'm good. Uh-oh. I'm sure I'll get warmed up when I'm in battle. Hey! Hey! Whoa! What the? Oh, it's Nepsy.
Like how their noses disappear with a surprise.
Hey, we came to play! Ooh, I'm a rhymer.
Are you feeling better?
I hate rhymers.
Yeah, definitely. That being said, sorry, Nepsy. We'll play another day.
Oh, that's too bad. Hopefully, we'll still be able to play after your big battle.
You think a good number of the Dreamcast worth talking about would have been ported remade? Same with the 32X. That is true of the Dreamcast for the most part, but the Sega Saturn and 32X were not. Like, multiplat really wasn't a big thing until Generation 5? Or no, 6. The one with PS2. Yeah, I think there are some direct Carmen Ryder references in this, but there's a lot of references to pretty much any big anime you'll find at least something. I probably don't notice them because I don't watch Kamen Rider or most any anime, really. I think the last anime that I watched through in its entirety was probably FLCL for like the fifth time. Oh, it's not an anime? It's not an anime? What is Kamen? Oh, right, that's a live action thing, right? I don't watch live action things either, so not much difference to me. I don't really watch too much. Like, I tend to play games or read stuff as far as my, you know, leisure time is concerned.
Yeah. You can count on it.
Wow, what an obvious death flag. Why are you rushing into battle? You should play and have fun first before doing anything so serious.
I don't feel like playing. As long as Dreamcast is out there, the world is going to end in ruins.
Oh, stop saying that! I already explained this to you.
I guess Sagami couldn't come up with a plan.
Guess not. She wouldn't be freaking out like this if she did.
Later. I'm out of here, Nepsy.
Obviously, we just have to go and beat both of them up. This is my secretly the PS2. That would be a good... I'm lagging? Oh my god. I hate you so much, Mediacom. Hold on. I'm streaming at 1 megabit up. 1 megabit. My phone gets more up than this. Okay, I only dropped 8 frames in like 10 seconds. I think maybe it's okay. Okay, I guess I just can't increase it over 1,000 megabit, or 1,000 kilobytes per second. Bits, kilobits. Hate this. I have to yell at Mediacom after this. This is freaking ridiculous. Yeah, I pay for over 10 times what I'm currently getting. It's still dropping frames. It's not many, but what the hell? I hate this. this so much. Okay. Wow. Let me do the speed test again. I'm pretty sure my... I really wish it had a it was better at, like, auto-refreshing for you. It says I'm getting 7 megabits up on YouTube. It says it's offline? Hold on. Beam, what is your deal? It does say it's offline. What the hell? Beam, you suck! What is your problem? Let me just make sure everything's working on my side. On my PC. Yeah, Beam is having problems. What the hell, Beam? Oh my god. Beam, I'm freaking streaming. I think you might still be back when I was having trouble, James. Beam connect. Okay, I think it's... No? It's back? It's actually not working for me for Beam, but if it's working for you guys, that's fine, I guess. Oh my god, this is so dumb. Why does streaming have to be terrible? I have the best internet. I have the best internet connection I could possibly pay for in my area, and it doesn't fucking work. Goddamn asinine. Okay, yeah, Beam's working for me too. Yeah, Matt 2 is Matt 2 is less laggy. Beam is definitely way less laggy, Matt 2. I can actually get the lag even lower, but I have to, I have to stream directly to Beam, so I would either have to multi-stream or only stream to Beam, so I think I'm gonna do a test stream of that sometime. I'll announce in advance. But yeah, Beam is definitely less laggy because what it is, the Beam's with the restream lag and my multi-stream, it's less than 5 seconds stream lag, and on Twitch and YouTube, it's about 20 seconds. And yeah, it is still a work in progress, but, oh, and if you have issues on Beam, I do have transcoding on, so you can watch in 480p, if you wanna, you know, go down a bit. Yeah, I've been quite impressed with Beam, and I want to try that Tachyon thing. Tachyon, so the lower latency you're seeing is about 5 seconds. It's like 0.2 seconds if I use the direct-to-beam thing that I could use. So I'm going to plan a stream for that sometime. Okay, I've stopped dropping frames, so I guess I just have to stream at 1 megabit up. People say Discord is so much better than Skype, it's not entirely true just yet. If you need video calls, it's not true just yet. For everything else, Discord is way better in my experience. I immediately stopped using Skype. I really, really prefer Discord. And if you have a Discord, you can join my Discord straight from Beam, actually.
You finally come. I will defeat you today and bring peace back into this chaotic world.
So they ended up fighting anyway. It must be fate.
You can't go against fate, you know. Why is everyone such an idiot? What are you gonna do, Iffy?
How do you mean? I'm just here to watch. But just in case things start to get crazy, we should be prepared to escape at any moment.
Oh, I probably should have saved. That's
Why are
fine.
You so cold? We should stick around and try to help. Are you forgetting I was born right after this era? I know how this ends.
All
right. Well, I'll keep my engine warm so we can bail whenever.
Easy there, Turbo. I can't stand this. I'm jumping in. Jumping in? What?
But would you even resolve anything?
Let her do what she wants, Nip. Who cares?
What? Why wouldn't you stop her? You seem a lot more careless about what happens in this era, Iffy.
Well, yeah. Whatever happens won't really change my era much. How could it?
You've been enlightened, I see. Yeah, you should try to apply for a job as a mage or something.
I'll stick to adventurer. So, Sagami, which one of these dummies are you gonna side with?
Oh, right, we have to pick sides, don't we? I totally forgot about this. This is the one thing you do. Okay, I said earlier that there weren't branches. I totally forgot about this part. There actually are branches. It's just which characters you side with, and this is the one thing that you might have to do a game loop for to see the other things, or just do an alternate save and look at both. It does not, at least as far as I saw, it does not affect anything other than, you know, you'll get a slightly different scene. I think you fight the one you don't side with, obviously. So, but you don't, like, get a bad ending if you pick the wrong character or anything. It's all up to personal choice. So we're gonna side with the Neptunia characters.
I'm going to help Uzume.
Huh?
Was it something I said? I thought you were siding with Dreamcast.
Well, Uzume just recovered, and to have everyone gang up on her would be so...
Oh, my. You like her, don't you?
No! It's not like that! Don't you grin at me like that! Well, no complaints here. Uzume, I'll fight with you too.
Nepsy, really?
Of course! Friendship! Why am I even trying to make that joke work in this version? Let's just show them what our friendship is made of!
Some writers from Carmen Ryder helped write Victory? That's interesting. It's probably my least favorite writing in the series, aside from the Blanc game. But, interesting. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it only changes the immediate scenes. You get, there are different ending scenes, but I think the way that was decided was by voting. Like, they chose whether you, like, they had a poll for Hard Girls or Neptunia, and Neptunia won, so the ending CG is of the Neptunia characters. And, they added as a free DLC, you could see the CG for the they made one for the Sega characters, too. And my internet is sort of working. Oh, it's dropping frames again. Of course it is. I hate Mediacom so much. They suck. They're horrible. I hate them. Not that there's really any good. I really wish Google would just completely consume Verizon, Time Warner, all those trash, awful people. Second thought, I thought it made sense to consider Uzume because the Dreamcast was reported for a very short time. Uzume is also Dreamcast, though. Zombie one is Blanc, right? Yeah. It's... It had some good potential to be great, and then it was like, no.
Nap.
Helping you.
The fate of the world is on the line. I don't care what it takes.
Yeah, and you're the one who's trying to ruin it. Ugh, forget it.
Yeah, this kind of makes a lot of sense if you think of it. I don't think it's exactly intended to be this, but it kind of reminds me of Sega America versus Sega Japan. Like, they were awful to each other. Like, it was ridiculous. Yeah, Uzume is basically Dreamcast. Like, she's... I wouldn't even call her a fictional console based on it. You know, she's a parody based on it.
You may have defeated me before, but I'm not letting it happen again!
Can I win?
Time to end this! I excel in magic too! Not that.
I can go anytime!
I guess it could make sense for this to be based on that, but... which side is Sega USA? Which side is, you know, they're both the Japanese, like, series, and I don't know how much Sega of America really mattered in the Japanese market. It was definitely a big problem over here, but I'm not sure if that those tensions would be as relevant. Maybe it was, I don't know. Alright. Just like last time, we're gonna start with the fever. You said Genesis is in this game. She's a chirper character. She, you see her, but she's not like one of the main playable characters.
I'll send your soul to hell!
We're trying to help her, Iffy.
Show me your shine! Fall into hell! Final defense! Headliner has arrived!
I think I can just barely show off everyone's EXE if I do this right.
This is me going all out.
Maybe not. I'm not sure. I'll try.
What do you think? It's pretty good, huh? I'm not done yet. Ta! What should I do?
Oh, I can. Cool. Assuming I can reach off her with all of them. She's always tired because of the Game Gear's batteries. Audio mixing really isn't great in this, unless I forgot to change it. I thought I reduced the audio, the music audio, and I could still barely hear her. I get that she's kind of, like, supposed to be a quiet character, but... Oh, they had strength and int down. I didn't even notice that. Wait, is that a debuff from casting the spells, or did Dreamcast get a turn? What was the central gameplay for the Blanc game?
This is all I have!
The main game plays like Neptunia U.
Max beam output!
And multiplayer works like sort of like Monster Hunter.
We will carve our way into the future! This will be good.
The voices are mostly alright, but Game Gear talks more quiet, and it's not like stage whisper quiet, where it's like not actually quiet, but they're like sort of whispering. But like, she's just actually hard to hear over the music. At least with the, at least over Nep Gear's theme. That's the, song that plays during the attacks.
I'll show you what a CPU is made of!
Can I reach? Oh, I didn't know she had this. That's neat. Once used, action will end. Huh, so you can force everyone into a defense mode with Nepgear. I didn't know that. That's pretty neat. That actually reminds me a lot of... There's a skill that does that in Criminal Girls, which is really useful. Like, it makes a defensive character basically required. Which is less of an issue in 3, or in CG2. It's not an issue in CG1 anyway, because the defensive character is the best character in the game. Because she's just cool, but still. I think I just need to get you closer. Aw, no, I forgot to equip skills!
I'll finish this at once!
Aw, frick. If you can see any Carmen Rider in Neptunia, it's definitely Carmen Rider XA being a video game based on Carmen. Don't they do the Carmen Rider thing? Where they like somebody is used as
Here
a weapon?
Ouch! Right there!
What should
Not
I do?
Bad.
And Neptune turns into a jet in one of her stupid things, doesn't she?
Chain
is that I assume that must be some sort of Any reference time. To something.
Nowhere to hide.
Not yet!
Brace yourself.
Not bad!
I get that she's supposed to be, like, tired and stuff, but I figured she would at least punch instead of do the slaps.
I'm ready.
Kinda lame. And she's also the only one without a weapon, so I figured she'd, you know, bare knuckle it, but whatever.
Multiple beam launcher!
Which clearly fires exactly one beam. Not sure this is even worth.
I guess
3,000 isn't too bad. I've actually had some boss battles last so long that I got two fevers in. It's not common though.
Not bad.
Ow!
What are you doing?
I just lost to that
fighting.
Any time.
I love when things miss. Alright.
How's this?
I was just taking a break.
Description of Neptunes is another reference to Decade with Destroy of Worlds and Deno Part 2. Huh. Like I said, I wouldn't really notice something like that myself. I kind of wish I didn't pick Game Gear for this. She's
great.
Kind of dead weight right now. I do have an attack skill for her. I just forgot that I didn't save after equipping it. And I rage quit after the last stream. I'm still kind of dropping frames. I'm streaming at 1 megabit per second up. Which is freaking, that's like mobile stream tier stuff. And I'm still having problems.
Time to end this. I'm giving it my all in this.
Someone is asking on Twitter how NepSega is while I am... They literally replied to the thing telling them that I was live streaming it. It's like, if you wanted to know, you could probably just literally open the stream and watch. And also, I'm probably not going to reply while I'm streaming. Heal you.
It'll be.
There we go.
What do I do?
No, don't.
Uh-oh. What should I do?
Didn't realize this track had vocals. Nepgear is kind of... Alright, there we go.
I'll use this.
That's perfect.
Oh, not bad. Ouch. Leave it to me.
Oh, damn it. I need to move you two. This is a net bowl.
I'll use this item.
Time
to end this.
Aw, oh, stop it!
It's my turn!
Not now.
Unfortunately, that cancels her transformation, which cost me some SP. Aw, oh, damn it, stop that! I really wish I had some other character other than her.
Ugh, just this one time, okay?
I promise I'll hit you.
Not finish this at once.
I think I can actually do more damage with her with normal attacks.
Go! Right there!
Time to end. I accept.
Did you stop that?
What should I do?
You're fine.
Show you what a CPU is made of!
Looks like that lightning strike dealt this guy a damage. You can break the damage limit in this, but not to Disgaea levels.
I'll handle this!
Not yet! Go! I'm going to hit it!
I think Nepgear is using more more gauge than other characters. Hit as many times.
Not bad!
We really should still be fine.
Eat this! Not bad!
Flame soul slice!
Bad. Time to end this!
Aw, oh, come on!
I end it.
No! I'll How dare you!
Losing consciousness.
It would be literally impossible for one of my characters to be able to do that. I guess not quite, because I don't. Come on!
I can go anytime.
Ugh.
I'll finish this at once.
Let's just heal everybody and get out of here. Crap, I can't heal Neptune like that.
I'm using this, all right?
Let's just spread out a bit.
What do I do?
You know what? Fine. Go ahead and use your ultimate attack against my least useful character.
Not yet.
Oh, wait, no, she's dealing. She doesn't have increased blade. Never mind. I think she has a skill that deal more damage for increased turn gauge use.
It's my turn.
But I don't have it used. I'm not using it right now.
I'm using this, all right?
I can still fight.
Here you go, Nip Gear.
I'm using this, all right?
What should I do?
What do I do?
Nothing. Nothing. I can go anytime.
Also, Nip Gear, heal yourself.
Not bad.
You'd be kind of close to getting a second fever. I'd definitely be able to defeat her with a fever. Which is kind of tempting, but I don't want to add... Using a charge attack builds you some more fever, but it also adds a bunch of delay, so I'm not really sure it's a net gain in terms of stuff.
Let's prepare
fever stuff.
I'll handle this.
Do your best for me.
This is also the first Neptune game where just moving behind an enemy isn't always the best idea because it uses up some of your gauge. So sometimes you might just want to hit them if you're already in range. Because you'll get in a couple extra attacks instead. Alright,
I promise. But
you're not bad.
3%, I'm not sure that's worth it.
I'll delete it!
You and your freaking one-hit KOs! How dare you! So really don't need to revive anyone past 50%.
I'll finish this at once!
Come on! That's the problem with using high delay attacks, is that she'll hit multiple times. What's my skill do? Nothing too interesting. Wait, recover 300 SP for an ally? That can't do that. Oh, you can cancel and I thought that was for my characters. Recover 300 SP. I don't think this is gonna work like I hope it will.
Leave it to
I think they actually have to have a virus, and then you can restore 300 SP. Oh, come on! Starting to lag? I think I dropped a few frames. No, Sega Saturn, for whatever reason, is the leader-ish character of the Sega Hard Girls. I don't know why, because I don't think the Sega Saturn was that popular even in Japan. It was barely here at all, but... YouTube doesn't look too bad for me. Get some cheer. Reviving you.
Leave it to me.
I can go anytime.
Saturn's funnier. Yeah, I haven't seen the show myself.
What should I do?
Yes!
We're gonna be very close to just building up a second fever. You know what? Let's just put everyone into defense.
Back down.
Let's see how this works.
Time to end horn down!
Let Netgear handle this.
Dang, not bad. Let's give you a netball.
I'm using this!
Fully Americans are really the Dreamcast. They seem to do that for the Saturn? Really?
Prepare yourself! Holy
huh.
Not bad.
Would not have guessed that. There's the one-hit KO. I'm not sure I should have done that.
Anytime.
Leave it to me! I'll delete
what
it!
What should I do?
I think she's not hitting Iffy because her stats would be higher with the transformation state. Saturn had a lot more release in Japan.
Anytime.
At this point, I guess I basically am better off just getting this fever.
Time to end this! I'll delete
Let
it!
Let Netgear handle this!
Is this a spin-off for an actual game in the series? I mean, it's an actual game, but it is a spin-off. It's not a mainline game. Hey, Way Too Dawn, by the way. And hey, Shokubro and Matt, too, by the way. I think I forgot to say hi. I'm glad she doesn't have any, like, burst AoE, like, centered around her character. I'm not even sure that's a thing in this game. It is in other Neptunia games, but this one seems to only have circle on target AoE. Oh no, she had three turns.
It's my turn.
Okay, that was a little dangerous.
What do I do?
Wait, what?
I won't. I'll delete it.
No!
I'll end it.
Why do you have so many turns? Fuck off! What the hell? Oh my god. Alright. What the fuck? Alright.
I'll finish this at once.
I guess it's because I did that charge attack earlier. I guess one thing I'm not used to, in Neptunia games, using an item is usually very low delay. I really just need this damn... Can I heal more than one person? I'm not used to items causing significant delay, because if you use two items in one turn, it seems to count as pretty significant delay in this game. I really just need a freaking fever now.
What should I do?
Alright, we're at 90. I'm getting into the expensive healing items too, this is annoying. Oh, she's not KO'd. I thought she was. Just use some of my good stuff.
Brace yourself.
Not bad.
This will nowhere to hide.
I'm gonna end my turn short because of freaking delay. I'm pretty sure getting KO'd adds some delay to you too. Just very annoying. I'm so annoyed that freaking Game Gear, all of her SP is useless because I don't have good skills attached to her.
Right there.
God damn it, how do you get so many turns?
Do something.
Please go to 100.
I promise I'll
hit you. Not bad anytime!
There we go. Alright, we've just won. She has like... She has so freaking little health, I almost don't need to use this, but whatever. I'll just end it in style, I guess.
I'll send your soul to hell!
There we go.
Show me your shine! Fall into hell! Final defense!
She survived that?
Headliner has arrived!
Whatever.
This is me going all out!
It's nice that Fever lets you get everyone get off one attack, the one EXE attack. You can also spam three attacks from one character if you prefer.
Rest a little.
There we go.
Not a good win.
I've obtained a new power.
That was only worth one level? You gotta be kidding me.
I've earned level up.
I can feat. I can fight trash mobs and get like one or like a level right now. Like that mattered.
Well. I'm sure you were able to predict these results, then.
We would have won without Uzume.
Probably because you didn't fight at all.
I was in perfect condition today. You just ganged up on me.
Just so you know, I'm sorry. This isn't personal.
It weirds me out that the portraits make it look like Uzume is shorter than Dreamcast. I would expect Uzume to be tall.
The least I can do is finish you with one blow so you won't suffer.
That's not really what we're trying to do.
Stop!
Uzume.
What? Isn't this what you wanted? Why did you even help me?
No, so weird.
I just...
Yeah, what was the game plan here, genius? Shut it, crap bike!
If I don't defeat her, the world as we know it will be destroyed. Move!
No, I won't let you! I have do something!
Do something? Dreamcast, get up! Run for it!
Really? Sure! I can do that!
Wait, damn it! Dreamcast, come back! Alright, let's go home now.
We're just gonna leave?
This is the note we're leaving on?
I already told you, nothing matters. We can't fix the future from here.
Uh-oh, she's nihilist.
Segami, you're cool if we leave, right? Of course not. How can you say nothing matters? Yeah, yeah, you can whine about it later. Nep, let's roll.
Okay. Well, see you, Uzume. Sorry for the trouble.
Nihilist, man. Say what you want about the tenets of National Socialism, but at least it's an ethos.
I can worry about that later. Dreamcast, wait!
Oh, one thing I was planning to fix, so with the multi-stream, everyone's kind of chatting on different channels, and it's a little annoying that, like, you can't see other people unless you watch the chat on stream, but, Restreamio, the thing I use to multi-stream, they're making a service so that'll, they're making a chat bot so that I would be able to, like, shove everybody's chat into all the different chats, which is something I plan to do as soon as they can. There's this thing called Scorpion Bot that I think can connect Beam and Twitch, but yeah, I really want that restream feature because I think it'll cover everything. There's other bots that already do that. I know that I've seen things do that for multiple Twitch channels and for Beam and Twitch, but I've never seen anything that does it for YouTube. Which is, like, most of my chat tends to happen on YouTube unless it's on Beam. So if I could shove YouTube and Beam into Twitch, that would be ideal. Because Twitch chat, people tend to be, like, people on Twitch tend to bail if they don't see much chat going on. Because, I mean, obviously Twitch chat is one of the most pleasant experiences that mankind has to offer. Supposedly the monster sealed in the depths of the warehouse has awoken. Don't go near it, though. Leave that to me. Alright, so that is a hint that, there's a big boss in here, I think.
Now let's go.
I haven't played FE Fates. I played one Fire Emblem game. I actually rented the incredibly elusive GameCube one. Or is it the Wii one that's, like, super rare? But I rented one of them. And, this was before I got into tactical stuff, so I wasn't very good at it. Oops. Keep running IF. Get that baseball. Yeah, I had no idea it was gonna be like a rare thing or anything. But, I just didn't really get into SRPG stuff until Disgaea, and I don't really like many SRPGs that aren't Disgaea, honestly. Especially with all the permadeath. I do not enjoy permadeath as a game mechanic at all. I do like some roguelikes, but when it's like... The thing about a roguelike is when you die, you totally start over. In an SRPG, when one character dies, I can't deal with that. And sometimes you have to let people die to get other people joined. It's like, no. And then there's this game called Yggdrasil Union. I love the game, theoretically, but it has so much missable crap. You absolutely need a guide, and there's no grinding. And there's permadeath, which the permadeath is like the least of worries, but there's so much stress in that game. Everything you do is just so... There's so many ways to screw up, and a lot of it really isn't your fault, because you have to do all kinds of ridiculous stuff. Like, you gotta bring a specific character to this one tile that's way out of your way at night, and have this one other item that you got five levels back that you also use this specific character to go to a specific tile. And you could only get that if you got... it's just this internet-connected, you know, trial of complete bullshit that's... Oh my god. Phew, I think we finally observed history through all of the eras. You sure? I don't think we saw everything. I'm not satisfied with this at all. Yeah, iffy. Sheesh. The histories were set. How can you be dissatisfied with that? Besides, we still have more to do in other eras anyway. Stop crying about it. I'm not crying. I just hate feeling like we missed something. Same. Sagami, you're way too sensitive to this line of work. Shut up, Neptune. Shut up, Neptune. What? You think I'm temperamental? Shut up, Neptune. Huh? What's with that reaction? If you don't tell me you feel the same way as Neptune... Hello, everyone. Oh, I never said people on Twitch were trolls or anything. I just said people tend to bail if they don't see chat and stuff. I don't mind my Twitch chat. It's just kind of weird to me that people consider chat, like, a super essential part of the experience. Like, chatting with the streamer, yeah, that's fun when it happens, but a lot of Twitch streams that I watch, I tend to just watch passively. And like Vinesauce, I see no reason to watch that at all on, like, live, personally. I just watch the VODs for Vinesauce, because, I mean, it's not like they kind of look vaguely at chat sometimes. Anyway, being able to turn on permadeath was not well received. It wasn't well received, but I seriously doubt Fire Emblem sales would be as good as they are if it was still permadeath only. Do you think the people who got angry had the Dark Souls get good mentality? Permadeath does change the gameplay, because if you get KO'd in a permadeath game, like, and you want to save all the characters, you have to play a lot more defensively. So, like, it does have some gameplay effects. Oh yeah, Final Fantasy Tactics. Final Fantasy Tactics was my first permadeath game, and I actually really hated it because my first character went down before I had any freaking Phoenix downs, and I'm like, I can't fix this. I didn't like it. And you know, the thing with FE Fates, it's a choice. If you don't like permadeath, you know, or if you do like permadeath, just leave it on. It's all you gotta do. Hello, everyone. Wow, great timing. Rebecca's for. Hey, don't ignore me. Answer my question. Oh, I apologize. That'll have to wait. I have some very important information to report to you three. Report? Ugh, is it really that important? We're in the middle of something. Yes, it's very important. You have all just observed the history in one of the lost eras, correct? Well, yes, but why do you look so concerned? I'm feeling more confused, really. You see, all this history has been set for the areas you visited. It seems as though history as a whole is still unstable. I believe it's a side effect of your travels, but... I'm not following at all. Histy, use normal words, please. But I am using normal words. I suppose it would be faster for you to see it for yourselves. Why don't you say that sooner? Look over here. Don't be too loud. Just take a quick peek. This is so dumb, but... Huh? Why are we here? Oh. Hi. Don't ask me. I've got no idea. So I guess this answers your question earlier about why can't we just fix, like, the earliest era? We have fixed Dreamcast's era, so they survived. What? Why are they all here? I think in order to save them from the danger of the unstable eras, the library's keeping them here temporarily. That sounds a little unbelievable, don't you think? How did this even happen? I don't really know. This is absolutely unprecedented. I see, but even if it's only temporary, it shouldn't be much of a problem, right? What? Why do you say that? Yes, what do you make of this? I'm just saying, doesn't this mean we can use their help when we battle that bastard out of here? Oh yeah, we can use them. Like, the point is we can use the real them to fight the Time Eater. Promise of this game is similar to Final Fantasy Record Keeper? Huh. I tried Record Keeper, but I really don't like the timed events. Like, that's something in mobile games, like, it's very popular because it, like, forces people to play a lot, but I really hate, like, oh, sorry, you wanted Squall, but, you know, we already had a Squall event, so I guess you gotta wait 18 years for another one. It's like, ugh. My problem with, like, DLC, microtransactions, times events, and all of that basically boils down to, when I get a game, I want to get access to all of it. I don't want to, like, worry about, oh, you got to play on a leap year that's divisible by 69 in order to get, you know, your favorite character. And, you know, you got to pay $18, you know, per life crystal to bring back characters every time they die. And, you know, no, just, I want to play my fucking game. And yeah, like I was saying earlier, yeah, the permadeath does affect gameplay in FE Fates. I don't mind permadeath as an option, but I don't really... I would prefer generally that there's an option to turn it off. That's why I prefer my Disgaea as far as SRBG stuff is concerned over the Final Fantasy Tactics. The Final Fantasy Tactics wasn't... It was like soft permadeath. So I'd have to have it never troll you since I enjoy your stuff. Well, thank you. Hey, Wild Jeff 2, am I planning to play Dragon Ball Z Universe 2? Probably not at the current rate. I'm pretty busy with stuff. Speaking of busy with stuff, I'm getting my PSVR next week, and I'll have a non-VR Thumper video up for Monday. So that should be fun. And I'll be doing some PSVR videos as soon as I actually get it and can record them and stuff. I'm a little scared as to how well that's going to record. But it'll be interesting, at least. Can you, for once, not in your life, make it not sound so awful? I'm just kidding! Shouldn't we just leave them alone here? That would be mean. You're right. We should say hi. Hey, everybody! Nepsy? Did you jump into this era? Maybe this is your... Calm down, everyone. You're gonna explain everything in a minute. Time skip. I see. So, I'm pretty sure this is just generic dialogue, because they're saying everyone instead of specifying the characters. I see, so in other words, you jumped to the future. Yep. Wow, how'd you do it, Nepsy? I didn't do anything. Surprise. I'm surprise. Quell surprise. I'm surprised you two were so quick to accept our story. Well, I am such a hard girl. Does that mean you're stupid so you accept things that we tell you? Doesn't seem surprising that a modern girl is visiting the future. Okay. That still seems pretty surprising to me. The only weird thing in Fates is that many of the characters' death quotes has them retreat. Huh. Yeah, a lot of games, like, really, like... In a lot of games, like, death is used as, like, something that isn't actually death, like... People are, like, over-dramatized things that are clearly not dying because of, either gameplay or story reasons. You're here too, Izume. You're both pretty amazing. It's really cool that we've arrived here, but... It really is ruined, isn't it? Yeah, and it's all because you two wouldn't stop fighting. Thanks, losers. It's because Dreamcast wasn't defeated, that's why. No, it's because Izume wasn't destroyed. I told you that's not it. Hey, stop right there. Can you leave the drama in the past and be friends now? I know. So you want us to battle the Time Eater with you, huh? You're oddly accepting this. Fighting with my sworn enemy of yesterday. Wow, my story is getting way cooler already! Seriously, we can't let such a cool opportunity pass us up. I love that the Dreamcast characters are so focused on cool things, because that's such a Dreamcast thing. 90s Sega was all about the cool and the edge. Stuart's surprisingly getting along. I know, wonder if it's because they never tried becoming friends. Oh, they usually maimed if they're relevant to the story. That makes sense. Wrong time and place, I'd say. I think things are just gonna get better from here on out, though. Alright. It's officially a pleasure, Dreamzy. I can't say that I like the nickname, but it's a pleasure, isn't it? Uzume herself has joined. Time Fighter? How did you get such a badass second class? Speed Fighter. That is way less cool. Dreamcast. More like Memecast. So yeah, we have... Generally, I think the second skill is better. Status. So yeah, we now... Since we fixed time in that era, I think we have... I think that means the story for Dreamcast is done now. Alright, you have to go to the class. Class change to change your class, surprisingly. The only class we can control AG. Oh. Huh. So she's a time mage. AG means like action gauge, I'm pretty sure. Speed Fighter. AGI is incredibly high. Not sure that's really relevant. Like, I think AGI is just turn order. I'm not sure if it affects delay at all. But whatever. I'll try it out. Hey, Dreamzy. I'm Dreamcast. Nice to meet you. Let's do this together. I want to put down that sword. We're just kind of chilling here, you know? I bet she's a speed fighter because rolling around at the speed of sound. True. Though I guess everyone could be, you know, a Sonic reference, really. I guess maybe less so No, there was a Sega- there was a Sonic game for Saturn. My name's Unabi Teneboshi. You're in good hands now that I'm here. I really wish they had kept up the French naming thing. I think French for orange is just orange, though. So that might be a flaw in the plan, but they could find something fancy, I'm sure. Tenbuyer, as soon as the pre-order began, I bought everything. You monster. This guy. This guy! I hate this guy. Worst character ever. If you auction this online, you'll make so much money. I hate that guy. Because Dreamcast had the higher processing. I guess, but I mean, like, yeah, like you said, every console has the highest, you know. It's really, aside from the Wii and, like, the like portable consoles, you know, everything is always the newest or the best. Alright, and you can expand Toyopolis by doing one of those mission things. Alright, so I think we're done with story quests, and yeah. No more... Why are there ASIC remnants in this timeline? It's no Sega console, it's a Dreamcast. True, but... I don't know. Maybe due to her, like... Is that, like, a bit of her personality in the show, maybe? Like, I don't know how they act in the show, aside from how they, like, represent in this game. Observe. Alright, I'm gonna save before this, because there are a couple of fights that are really hard. And that Dreamcast was already... Oh. I'm actually kind of tired of you. Let's bring in Uzume. And Game Gear. Dreamcast, sure. Just to change things up, but I also want to set some skills. I want everybody to have at least two skills. Two attack skills, rather. Edge. Unfortunately, Plutia's first class is all focused on healing. And I don't really care too much about that. Okay, you definitely, yeah, Blade Dance. Actually, I want that drop rate, so yeah. Oh, she can revive ally to 50%. It's so weird when games, refer to being knocked out as death and deceased, and it's, like, clearly not actually the case. Like, just, like, revive KO'd character or something. Like, they're just fine the very next fight. They are obviously very much not dead. Buy a ton of life fragments. Oh, right, we haven't bought items in a while, have we? God damn, that's a little pricey, but IF tends to be my main character, so... Thinking on it, why is that guy here? There are still people alive in this era, I think. Let's just buy the weapons for all of our current characters. Ooh, it has a chance of increasing ailment. That's really cool. All right, do we have better armor? Oh, yes, we do. All right, let me just buy, like, how many characters do we have? 10? Yeah, we have 10. Let's just buy 5 of these and 5 of these. Controller. Did I just crash? PC, please. Did I just crash? What happened? No, I didn't crash. Why is this not working? Oh. Oh, I don't have enough money. I thought my PC froze. That happened to me during a stream before, and I was about to have an aneurysm. I did not expect it to stop me. Okay. Crisis averted. I was going to say some bad things. Okay, let's equip my crap. I did not expect to be out of money, but whatever. Orange necktie. Oh, you're not wearing... At least wear the stamina thing. Oh, dang, I'm all mixed up, because I thought I saved. I did some work and last stream, and then I didn't save, because I figured I would just, you know, continue, but I guess, whatever. Yeah, a bunch of Sega Hard Girls just happened to be... We don't really learn too much about what's going on in the present. There just seem to be people here. Let's see what's going on here. Arcade stuff isn't really relevant to... I mean, there's some references, but... Add common skills. Skills are important. The more the better, so don't forget to add them. So yeah, this means we've unlocked our, we've unlocked quests for Dreamcast and, Uzume to add more common skills and increase the cap level, the class level cap. Talking about a park food bank. So yeah, once we complete the story in a world, we get the non-clone versions of the characters to play as. See, as you can see, there's no clone on Dreamcast and Uzume anymore. We can also increase their max class level from 20 to 50 after a quest, and then also add one more skill slot. I forget how we get the fifth skill slot, but it does happen. I think I just saved. Yes, I did. Alright. Alright, before all of that, I was just going to go check out this mission. I hope this isn't the one with Plutia. If we fight... Wait. This is Saturn. Obviously, we're not going to fight Plutia.
You don't need to tell me twice. I mean, my body's at stake here, too. Oh, while we're talking about that, Iffy, I'm so thankful that you've been looking out for me. You're a true friend.
Nep, I just want you to get out of my damn bike already.
Oh, stop that. I know you love me.
Oh, the Sega Hard Girls anime is on Crunchyroll? I didn't know that. I should probably get a subscription to that sometime. I got a trial subscription once. And I don't think I watched literally anything, actually. Like I said before, I don't really... watch a lot of stuff passively, because, like, I tend to multitask a lot, and I don't want to pause it, but I don't, like, want to miss it, and it's like, I just end up not watching things at all.
Whatever helps you sleep at night.
Oh, it's free? Right now? Huh. How awful are the ads, though?
Shut up already. Okay, so if I'm right, we're at the point in history where... we'd be in the middle of the last battle. We need to hurry. We came all this way, and we can't just stop here.
Oh, look at him go!
Ads aren't bad, 1-2 per episode. Oh, that's a lot less than I thought. Only simulcasts require subscribing.
All we have to do is watch until the end, and we're good.
I don't... Simulcasts don't really matter to me because I like watching all of a show within like a week or less. Cause like I really don't wanna, like with the new Danganronpa anime, I don't wanna watch and get stuck at a cliffhanger or something. I wanna just watch the whole damn thing. So like I'm not really very interested in watching it until it's done.
Oh no, we can't just sit and watch them fight. We need to stop them.
Duh.
Well, you know, I remember not wanting to fight at all. It'd be nice to give myself a friendlier history.
Wow, Crap Bike. You actually said something nice and sensible for once.
Imposter!
I'm much more than just a finely tuned speed machine, you know.
Okay then, let's go!
Okay!
Hey, wait! What now? You know what? Whatever. You can do whatever you want.
Though I gotta say, stuff like Crunchyroll, even if you have to pay, it's amazing how cheap stuff like that is. What's his name? The artist for a lot of, like, the Lupin series, promo covers and stuff, Brandy something? Was talking about on Twitter about how Crunchyroll's amazing because, like, you can buy, like, you can get, like, everything for $30, whereas, like, when he was a kid, and when I was a kid, you would spend like $30 on one VHS tape with like two episodes of an anime down at frickin' Suncoast. Like, the only anime I owned from back then was Dot Hack, and I got into that because of the games. I'm a big Dot Hack fan. That's one of the few animes I really have watched all the way through. Not that it's very long. Dot Hack Sign, anyway. I think this is a new one focused on the GU universe that I should watch at some point.
Of course I can. And it's the right thing to do.
So, Segami, which one are you planning on stopping?
Oh, so I think this is, in fact, the fight. I'm not sure if we can beat Saturn. I should probably build up Fever. This might be bad. But, one thing about... I never had cable as a kid. And so I never really watched a ton of stuff. I just kind of got used to not watching things. Like, we would watch... It's The Simpsons and Family Guy and King of the Hill on, like, I think it was Sundays, the animation shows all ran. And I just really never got too addicted to watching TV stuff, so I just never, you know, felt much of that itch, personally.
Huh? Which one?
Well, it's impossible to stop both of them at once.
Well, we're just going to talk to them calmly.
I don't think you have the time to do that. You're gonna have to side with one and do this fast.
Wow, Iffy. You're sounding kinda...
Bite me.
You're right. If we take one down, it might be easier for us to make our point. Alright, so...
Yeah, I heard there's no English dub. So yeah, this is the first time they've had English voice actors. We're siding with the... Unfortunately, I... Yeah, let's go. We'll go Neptune the whole way.
I'm gonna side with Crap Bike.
Oh, really?
What's with that reaction?
I honestly wasn't expecting that.
I wasn't either.
You've always favored the Sega Hard Girls, so I really thought you were gonna side with Saturn.
If I side with Saturn, it'd be totally unfair for you. We have to make the fight seem as fair as possible, or people won't be convinced.
Oh, okay. Hey, wait! Are you making fun of me? Yeah, she totally is.
Don't start. It's already been decided.
No, but I have to...
Who cares, Nep? Come on!
Sorry to interrupt you.
No, we're not.
Huh? What are you doing?
Iffy? Segami too?
Whoa, it's been a while since I've seen my human form. I'm pretty hot stuff, huh? Objectively speaking, of course. Don't you think, Iffy?
The bike? Why does it sound like me?
We'll explain that later. For now, we're just here to back you up.
Iffy?
We're gonna help you end this.
But this battle is between Saturn and me. You don't need to get involved. Oh, go ahead. This is a perfect handicap for me.
See? She's cool with it.
You better not whine about it after we take you down.
Yeah. And if you don't beat me with all this extra help, you're a bigger loser than I thought.
Rude.
Iffy, Sagami, and, I don't get what's going on, but you're me, right?
Why is Neptune separate heart from Purple Heart? They've always been like that. Well, oh, do you mean the bike? Yeah, Neptune's just the bike.
Yep, I'm Neptune too.
All right, Neptune. Please back me up. Let's make sure she never thinks about challenging me again.
All right, leave it to us.
The bike will obviously not actually be helping. Yeah, Neptune is still a bike when we come back to Saturn era.
It's my turn.
Oh crap, I forgot to heal SP.
It's my turn.
Oh. Yeah, I think... I'm pretty sure she's like a ridiculous roadblock. I think... Yeah, in my guide, I recommend being level 45. Like, that was not... That one-hit KO was not, like, a super attack. That was just, like, a normal attack. So we're actually gonna do... We're gonna pick something different. Yeah, I think you need to be around level 45. That's when I beat her in the Japanese release. You could probably beat her easier in, like, a few levels earlier with proper strategy, because, you know, when I was playing in Japanese, obviously it was kind of me, you know, brute-forcing it a bit, because I couldn't read all of the stat stuff. I didn't bother to learn exactly what all the skills did. But I'm pretty sure we'll have an easier time with some of the other stuff. Unfortunately, I remember Pludia also being a big problem. So I think we're going to go to Game Gear. Wait, let's see how easy it would be. Oh, dang. We can get that skill slot for Uzume. Oh, we can get Dream Class skill slot immediately. Alright, cool. There's a lot of... It's kind of annoying that you have to do separate quests for every single character to unlock their skill slots and stuff, but the materials are always shared, so you can just grind up a ton of slimy vines and heat cloths, and I think that would get a lot of your characters ready. Where do we get heat cloth? Breakable object. Afterburner, lava, depth, blinky, Dreamcast. Okay. These quests were also a pain in the butt in Japanese, because I had to translate where things were to go find them. Good thing time travel tries you to an exact copy of the timeline instead of bringing you to the timeline itself. Not in this game, because we actually are changing, or fixing history at least. So, that's not how time travel works in this game. So after you find out about Time Key to recruit everyone and settle this war, and then all you do is side quests. Kind of, I mean, technically, as soon as you can fight the, I love the visual novel enemies. It's always hilarious when, like, people that don't know games very well, like, they'll complain about the series, because, like, somebody on NeoGAF was saying this. All the enemies in this game are so lame. I saw one that was just a 2D picture. It's like, yeah, it's a visual novel, because you're fighting video games. And yeah, those are Pac-Man ghosts. That's why I love, one of the reasons I love the series. I love the, you know, the reference enemies. There's always Pac-Man ghosts, there's always, Space Invaders. It's not the Time Meter from Sonic Generations. It will remind you of something from Sonic, though. Yeah, the quests, they're really short to get the skill slots and stuff. And yeah, once we do 5 more quests, we'll have to fight the time meter again, and then we lose, and then we restart the time loop. But all of our progress stays, so it's not really a problem at all. Yeah, the enemies are great. I don't know why, like... Also, certain skills, like the class level ones, and I think the skill slot ones, never expire. Though I think if you run out of time, you still have to fight. You still have to do another loop. What am I doing? I think you have to unlock your third class in order to get your fourth slot. Yeah, I really like the passive skills. I really like a lot of elements of this game's systems. Like, I like the classes. I like that weapons have innate effects like poison and stuff. I like being able to equip passive skills. I just wish it didn't come at the cost of active skills. I would like it if I could keep all of my active skills and just select which passive skills to have. Like, I've seen lots of games like that. Span out of range. I don't want that drop rate. 5% with the magic SP. See, you got lots of cool passive abilities that we don't really see too often in other Neptunia series stuff. Why do problems stay solved? Because we're fixing history. We're not, like, it's not quite like Majora's Mask. What we're trying to do is put history back together. We're not, like, fixing one single, like, timeline. Exactly. I don't know. It's a little weird, but I much prefer this. It's, like, way lower stress. Alright, for the class level thing, we need to fight this turtle. And we need a bunch of those turtle shells. So you might as well, if you can beat it easily, you might as well just fight it a bunch of times to release a bunch of class levels at once. I guess let's check out, I don't recall the Game Gear being a roadblock, so let's check out Game Gear World. And we'll do that in, like, 1 minute. I need to refill my water and move my legs slightly. I guess I've solved my frame-dropping issues, but the stream kind of looks like crap. So I'll upload my local copy of this stream and any future streams where I can't stream at my higher bitrate, because it'll look a lot better. I'm going to yell a lot at my stupid ISP and see if this is some sort of problem they can solve. But I can't imagine what else it would be, because everything else works. But yeah, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Can someone explain how and why Nep is a bike? What do you mean, Neptune has always been a bike? So the problem is so created by the Time Meteor, and when you solve them, the universe corrects everything and removes your involvement. Sort of. I'm not sure about removing your involvement, but it has been mentioned that sort of we're helping time fix itself. Let's go back to Game Gear.
So we're back in this era again.
Neptune! Your sister has come to see you! Neptune, welcome back! Sister welcoming with a hug. There's nothing that could make me happier.
Ah, the cold metal on my skin. So nice. I just want to take it apart.
How typical of the crap bike and maniacal mechanic. Anyway, any ideas on what to do now?
We've just got to keep an eye out for that big happening the Game Gear was mysteriously referring to.
But we have no idea what it is or when it'll even happen.
Well, we're here. I'm sure we'll see it happen. Our problem is figuring out what to do until then.
Why don't we help Neptune out?
Help me? With what?
Yeah, you're a goddess, right? You must have some duties to maintain.
What? Did you even have goddess responsibilities, Neptune?
She's a goddess, okay? I'm sure there's something that needs to be done around here.
You totally ignored me.
Well, sure, I have things to tend to, but are you sure you all want to help?
Of course. I don't mind at all.
Honestly, I'm curious to see what a goddess actually does. We don't have much else to do anyway.
See? Everyone's into it. Let's go!
Okay.
Thanks, everyone.
I think we actually have to go back for another quest since that was considered finished. Because you can't play games in public in this area. There are many consoles just sitting in the warehouse. We still have obstacles to overcome with portable consoles, but if we can get perfect portable consoles, we can sweep the market. I'm gonna keep stocking my warehouse. Okay, Mr. Rabbit. My mother fell ill and I need medication. Get out! Get out! We're poor and we have... God damn it. We're poor and we have no money to die medicine. Something expensive! What? No, I'm not lying. I'm not trying to sell it. I swear my auntler's... Yeah, when you talk to these, they usually give you a quest, actually. So that'll be a quest to give her some medicine. Haha! Train with me and get pumped! Get swole! Let's win! This is Game Gear era. It says right up at the top. But it wants to be a big city cop or something, silly rabbit. Ugh, how dare you. I think that, I'm pretty sure that thing is from before, whatever that movie name is, Zootopia. Oh, hey, BP. Alright, I guess I should grind a little bit on the new classes. Oh, speaking of streams, I'm gonna be streaming at 6 Central, which is about in 4 hours. I'll be streaming Yumi Nikki for my spooky Saturday, or Sunday, whatever day this is. Yumi Nikki should suffer less from this lower bitrate, so that'll be nice. But, yeah, that should be fun. I think we ran out of time to do the Game Gear missions. Wait, what's this? I think if we can fight that, let's see if we can fight that turtle. Hey, Donatus? Donatus, I guess? I think he's the one. Wait. Was it Mega Drive era? Oh yeah, it must be. Let's go to Mega Drive. Is this out already? No, I think it's out in a week, like the 14th or 18th? No, this is a review copy. You ready for some spooks? It's not really, it's like not a jump scare horror game, it's like a surreal experience. But there's some spooky stuff. It's like, it's unsettling, not like outright horror, but it seems like exactly my kind of thing. The turtle is in the second region. I hope I can... I should be able to fight the turtle, I think. The one bad thing about this game being non-linear, it doesn't do a good job of telegraphing to you how easy of a time you'll have at any given level in a certain quest or whatever.
This all. Leave this to me. You need to disappear.
I don't know. I'm still, you know, ignoring NX
that
leaks.
Was a waste of time.
How fancy.
Yay! Level up! Yeah! Level up!
And you want to level your classes somewhat evenly just because you learn a lot of skills you can use on other skills. You learn a lot of skills you can equip when you're when you're the other class. 16th in America. That sounds about right. But yeah, I played the Japanese release and almost got the platinum. And I just have one more baseball to get. Wait a minute. That is not a turtle. That is not a turtle at all. There's supposed to be a big turtle enemy here. I guess I should have checked. I figured if it wasn't in that era, it had to be in this era. It must be in Game Gear? Oh, thanks for the follow. Oh, Cube Gear. Hello. Turtle. Here we go. Save before this. I actually need a bunch of turtle shells. So if I can fight this thing and not have a horrible time, I might just grind out a few. Gimme. I kind of hope that Cyberdimension has the sort of elements of traversal and collection that this game has for the maps. Strong co-branding effort. I don't know, everything in this leak seems very predictable. Like, I don't really trust any NX leaks at all. But it's like, it seems like a bunch of stuff that, like, are reasonable guesses. And co-branding doesn't make any sense, because, I mean, Mario is Nintendo. So, I mean, that's not co-branding, that's just branding.
Here we go.
They're actually releasing Four Goddess Online as an actual game. I mean, yes and no. It's just another Neptunia action game. Well, not another, but it's a Neptunia action RPG. And it's not an online game. It's a game set in Four Goddess Online.
Here we go.
And I would say quality-wise, this is around the, I would say it's around the remake's quality. It's not as good as Mega Dimension, and obviously didn't have as much budget. There's some issues here and there, but overall, it's, I would say it's my favorite of the side games. The one thing I was really worried, the only thing I was worried about after playing it in Japanese was how good the writing was gonna be, because in Blanc game, the writing was really bad. But, it's been quite good in this. So like the Dot Hack or SAO games. Yes, like something like that. It's, I'm not sure how much it's gonna bother to fake being an MMO. Because, I mean, since it's Neptunia, it kind of makes sense that, like, the digital world would be very important. And, like, they could always do some, you know, Dot Hack stuff where, you know, oh, things in the game are affecting, you know, people in real life or whatever. Or just it's affecting their shares or something. But, it's looking good so far. The one concern is the character models look like they're from the other games. I was kind of hoping we'd get a new set of character models. Especially with the Switch to Unreal Engine 4 and PS4 in general. I mean, we already had a PS4 game, but it didn't start on PS4. I'm not sure we're quite ready for the turtle.
Leave it to me. Now, who to choose?
So I got a thing that lets me escape from anywhere, but it doesn't give me 100% escapes.
Now, who to choose?
Ugh, that's annoying. So I can't kill that thing yet. That'll take way too long. Spinoffs usually use existing models. Cyberdimension is not... I would not call Cyberdimension a spinoff, though. The way the games tend to work is that IF does all the work on the side games, and Compile Heart is the one publishing the main games and stuff. And this one has been announced as, like, a Compile Heart game. So this is... basically one of the, it's a major title. I'm not sure if you'd call it mainline. Like, it's not a story and continuing game necessarily, but it definitely looks like a higher budget, you know, full-fledged title, not a side game that I would call. You know, it's sort of like how the MMOs in Final Fantasy, I wouldn't really call them mainline, but it's not a side game. It's like, you know, they have full budget and everything.
Let's go back to the original era.
What's this about Square? Is this leak tending to suggest Nintendo and Square? I don't know. What? Who said what about Square? 1080p and 60 FPS. I don't know if I... The whole hybrid thing, the only way I can see the NX being a hybrid is the portable being basically everything. And, like, there's just a docking station that just basically plugs into an HDMI thing for your TV. I can't imagine the console being, like, they would have to make two totally different things with different hardware to get the console thing to have different real specs. Because you can't really have a plug-in GPU and plug-in CPU. Like, you'd have to, it's kind of all or nothing. It's really hard to program for two GPUs that are, like, totally different and have it really be additive. Like, we're kind of past the point where we try to do weird shit like that. What's this thing about Square, though? I don't see any mention of Square in the, on this Nintendo, the subreddit for NX. What did I just say? The Wii can do 1080p 60, couldn't it? No. The Wii doesn't even output HDMI, it's 480p only. Like, I get what you mean, but, like, the Wii is physically incapable of outputting 1080p. But, I mean, it's technically a matter of power, but I don't really see them going 1080p 60fps for a handheld. I mean, their last console is a 240p 30fps machine, so... yeah. I really don't think Super Mario RPG 2 is happening. Nintendo doesn't even want two of their own Mario RPGs. Like, I really don't see them allowing Square to make one. Well, of course emulators can, it's not really the same thing. Hey, Ikaru... bleh. Words. Hey, Ikaru Zero. I'm not sure why this bridge is just missing. I think one of the chirper people you can talk to re-enables it.
Yep.
The Wii U playing Wii games? No, that's just an upscaler. The Wii... in Wii mode, it is not, like, outputting... the games aren't running at 1080p. They're running at 480p, and the Wii U is upscaling it for you. Skyward Sword ran at 60. Yeah, it could run at 60 frames per second. I'm not sure if... no, Skyward Sword definitely was not. They haven't made a 60fps console Zelda since Link to the Past that I'm aware of. It would be very unlikely for Breath of the Wild to be... especially as an open world game, for it to be 60. Oh, there's my baseball. Oops. Oh, and I keep forgetting to take a picture of the area I find the baseballs in. I guess I could just... Penny Cave, sure. It's close enough. I don't know, you could just... like, they're probably just transitioning to UE4 in general.
Address us every time you call us, you know.
Oh, then what should I call you?
You think about that later. You wanted to say something, right?
Yeah. I forgot.
Yeah, I know they've done collaborations between Square and Nintendo, but I just have to imagine that if Super Mario RPG 2 were gonna happen, it would have happened.
Monsters around here. Someone asked me to beat them up.
Are we dropping frames again?
You always have to be such a drag when you open your mouth.
Ugh, why all of the garbage? Oh, I guess it's up. Oh, no, it's not stopped. I'm streaming it at 1 megabit per second up. This is garbage tier internet stuff, and I'm still having trouble. I hate Mediacom. This is fucking unacceptable. This is $50 in internet. This is $50 a month internet. It's garbage. It's still dropping. I can't even freaking lower. Like, we're already at trash tier, like, video quality. I really can't go much below this. Ugh. Well, I'm gonna stop and start the stream again. Just hit refresh in a few seconds, and I should be back. If it's still dropping frames, I'll let the scene play out, and then I'll stop. Ugh. Google Fiverr, please save us. My favorite goddess? In this game? All of my favorite characters are not in this game. Of the characters in here, I guess I would say Uzume, maybe, or Mepgear. Like, Plutia and Neptune are my least favorites, so... Yeah, audio tends to do... Everything tends to focus on audio, so it doesn't look like... sound like crap. But yeah, I'm gonna bring it down and back up, and it's probably not gonna help. Oh my god, it's still dropping. I'm at 1 megabit per second, son of a bitch! What the hell? This is fucking ridiculous. Okay, you know what? Fuck. Whatever, I'm just gonna let this scene play out, then I'm gonna stop.
Aw, oh, stop it. I think Plutie's voice sounds great. I have to go find this monster. So...
Okay, sure. Let's go get that taken care of first. Well, I'll help too.
What? You're gonna come with me?
Of course. If I don't keep my eye on you, who knows what could happen?
It's dangerous to go alone. We're not gonna let you just walk into a battle by yourself.
Yeah, don't be shy, Plutie. We're here to help.
Wow! Thank you!
So, where's the monster?
I think it's this way.
Hey, don't run too fast. You seem a little clumsy and might trip or something. What's on your mind, Segami?
She's not a bad person, but she's so slow, it's painful. Is there anything even going on in that brain of hers?
I gotta hand it to you, Segami. That was an impressively backhanded diss.
Was that a Legend of Zelda reference? Do you have to ask? Like, that reference has been in, like, almost every Neptunia game.
Not wrong, Nep. It's hard for me to stick up for that one sometimes.
What I don't understand is why Mega Drive holds such animosity towards her. What happened?
Yeah, I don't know. It seems kind of strange if you ask me.
One, Plutie's hiding something. Two, Mega Drive's jealous of Plutie's looks. Three, she's just annoyed. Pick one.
Is there a correct answer out of these choices?
Well, it wouldn't be the second or third one. But what kind of secret would Plutie be keeping?
You know, you don't have to take Nep's jokes too seriously. Hey, we've been walking for a while. Are you sure we're going the right way?
I think so?
Ugh, you're so useless.
Maybe this ditzy persona is what pisses Mega Drive off so much. No, that sounds like a dumb reason.
Don't think about it too much. Why don't you just ask her when you see her?
Do you think she would even tell us?
Oh, Mr. Monster! Where are you?
Come out with your hands up! You're surrounded!
Shut up, Neptune.
We just wanna talk! We promise!
Yeah, we just wanna talk. Come out!
We'll figure out that Mega Drive thing later. Catching this monster is priority right now.
Okay, I stopped having frame drops for now. Now that I've said that, it's probably gonna start dropping frames again. Just for the purposes of tempting fate, try something. Let's try upgrading to slightly non-crap quality. Seems to not be dropping. Oh! One drop. Oh, my favorite goddess in this game would probably be Uzume or Nepgear. This game excludes basically all of my favorite characters though, so it's kind of a hard question to ask in here. Okay, yeah, increasing doesn't work, but I think I'm finally stable for one megabit per second up, which is like old cell phone tier upload speed.
I'm not sure I fully believe in this search method.
You've gotta believe! The criminal will always listen to you if you say things nice enough!
First off, it's a monster. Second, that's just nonsense. Besides, there's no way it'll come out just because you call it.
It's here!
Huh?
Look, you...
That thing is insanely small. Is this really the monster you were looking for?
I guess?
You don't sound too convinced. Are you sure this is it? This is the scary monster we're looking for?
Maybe you shouldn't judge it just yet. Maybe it's got some intense poison, or it's super vicious.
They were saying he was a meanie because he steals veggies from the farm.
Oh, is that so? Well, whatever. Let's get this over with fast. Huh?
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Where did all those come from?
So many friends. So lucky.
This might be more difficult than I expected.
Good thing we're here to help, huh?
Hey, Plutie.
What?
We're gonna give you support, but you need to take the lead on this. It's your job after all.
What? But I don't wanna be mean.
You're going way too easy on it. This monster is bad! It does not deserve your compassion!
Huh? Sagami? You're scary. Fine. Fuck you, fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! They keep popping up!
If any more come, we're gonna be overwhelmed. Let's start taking them down. Battle start.
All right.
What should I do?
Just a square soft selection of. Oh! They actually are decently high health.
Blood boiling!
There's like multiple layers of chocobo references in these games now. There's this thing, at least with this color. There's the actual chocobo looking things in Victory 2.
You just stay right over there. I can beat you up from here.
Oh dang. And there's the horse birds, of course. Yeah, she shoots columns.
Finishing blow! I'm a force of fury.
I think I might try something on my. I think I might try a stream from my other PC just to test. Just to see if there's something weird going on my PC, but I really think it just must be the internet connection. I mean, there's been other colors for chocobos for a while, but yellow is definitely the standard color for chocobos.
Let's go!
I'd have to do a bit of setup to try to test the stream from the other PC, though. And I can't really test without actually going live, which is annoying.
Let's go.
Dang, Mega Drive is pretty strong. Oh, frick! Oh, I should have been targeting the Heal Dagu. God damn it. I'm not used to them being a major problem. $10,000 in one heal. That's fine. Whatever. I guess I'll just build up fever and then murder this thing.
What should I do? I'm a force of fury. You're not half bad.
What do I do?
Wish they'd at least not be able to heal themselves, though they didn't really heal that much.
What to do?
There we go. All right.
This is great. I'm giving it my all in this.
There's a tiny sliver of health left. Right, let's focus on the other enemies first thing. Aw, no, I can't hit them both.
I'll send your soul to hell! Show me your shine! Fall into darkness!
Unfortunately, finishing it off would actually use a bit of my fever. So I just want to do all my specials first. Oh, don't say that in English.
I'm going for it. I'll give you a special drink.
Leave this. Let's see Mega Drives.
I'll show you my special.
Take that.
Someone really needs the break damage limit thing. There's a formation grid that lets you do that, so I could break damage limit, but I'm tired. Oh crap.
What do I do? Not the best day.
I've obtained a new power!
I'm gonna get level up. Do
I look cooler now? We took out a bunch of them, but there are still so many.
Ugh! They keep spawning. How many are there?
No. I'm tired.
Worst CPU
Stop
ever.
Stop complaining. You'll make it worse.
I really didn't think there would be so many.
There's more. It seriously feels like it'll never end.
This might not end well for us. Nep, get ready to make a break for it.
With so many of these things in the way,
I might not be able to gain enough speed to make a fast break.
Hey, get off of me!
No!
Stop! Stop pulling on my damn clothes, you asshole!
Yes. Young-looking girls being touched awkwardly by small monsters.
Shut up, Neptune.
In the meantime, my paint's getting chipped off by their little nails!
IF, we need to figure something out, or we're all gonna die here! What the hell are we gonna do?
I said stop, you meanies! Well, even Plutie is starting to get frustrated.
Is she? She still sounds stupidly calm right now, and it's really annoying! Plutia, you're a goddess, right? Can't you just transform and wipe these idiots out? Oh, right!
Plutie, you're our Plutia only fans. Hope!
I can't take this anymore!
Plutie? Your face is getting a little intense!
Everyone gets scared, so I try my best not to do this, but...
She transformed!
Okay...
Ludia?
These children need to be punished.
Oh, it's been a while since I've been in this form. I feel so beautifully liberated.
Is this even the same person? I think so.
Monster A is scared. Monster B is scared. Monster C ran!
There's nowhere to run. You will receive your punishment, and you will enjoy it.
She blocked it!
I'd much rather punish you all one by one, but I suppose I should annihilate you all at once.
One strike defeated almost all of them.
Wow.
I wonder what would happen to me if she hit me with an attack like that.
What? Sagami, do you want her to, hit you? I didn't know you were into that sort of thing.
I'm not! No way! Oh, shut up!
My, don't be modest. You haven't had your fill yet, have you? I still have plenty left to give.
Can we just leave her? Yeah.
I know she's dealing with evil monsters, but I can't stand to watch this.
This is what happens to those unfortunate few who cross Plutie.
I vaguely remember this. I just wish I didn't.
Aw, we're finished. Are you girls okay?
Yes, thanks.
Don't be a trash can.
I guess you saved us. Hey, do you think you can transform back now?
Not yet.
What? Why?
It's been quite a while since I've been in this.
Oh, fuck off.
I'm not satisfied yet. You all seem like you can handle a little more abuse.
Fuck you.
Whoa, what? Don't tell me! No. We didn't mean it like that. Whoa, girl!
What's the matter, girls?
Don't you want to play with me? No!
Yeah, let's just leave this part of the timeline to die. It'll be fine. Ugh. They just had to keep the worst aspect of Pludia from victory. I guess Blanc game is the only one where she's not a completely awful person.
I can barely stand to watch. That was gruesome.
I'm a little jealous that you're trapped in that bike.
Should've just let...
Sega masochist over here couldn't handle it? That must mean Plutie is a pretty scary gal.
Hey! I already told you I'm not like that! Don't put that label on me!
Can we please kill Plutie in her sleep?
Now she's just here sleeping away.
No one would mind.
This
no one.
This is going to be incredibly traumatizing. So, do you think this is why Mega Drive has been so hostile towards her? Ooh, yeah, definitely.
It appears you all understand now.
Yep. Speak of the devil!
You were spying on us? Some hobby. It's honestly a little weirder than Plutie's.
Stop that. I was just waiting for her to finish. Even I don't have the stomach to see her like that.
Did she get you too? In the past?
When I initially went to visit her after I discovered a goddess existed in this world, my appearance seemed to match her taste perfectly.
I feel like she'd go for anyone, though. She's a bit of an omnivore, if you know what I mean.
Shut up, Plutia.
So why'd you come here? Are you here to finish us off now that we've been weakened?
Although that does sound tempting, my pride couldn't allow such an unfair act to occur. I have something I'd like to inquire of you.
What is it?
I'm under the impression that you were unaware of Plutia's true nature. Now that you've come to know about it, do you still plan on trying to stop me?
Well, yes. Actually, I think I might just, you know, sit on the sidelines.
Ditto.
No matter what happens?
Yes, no matter what happens.
I don't understand why you're being like this. The people will place faith in her, and she will ultimately affect those who love games.
Yeah, let's
this
kill her.
This is a horrible thing. She's unfit to have that kind of influence over people.
That's not your call. It's up to the people to decide what's right and wrong.
No, she's right.
Why don't you just help them in your own way? They need games. Give them games, Mega Drive!
Yes, but Plutia's appetite will outweigh the needs of the people in the end.
I don't really know much about this. Who's in the right here now?
Yeah, all of the other Sega Hard girls are being unreasonable, but this is just totally reasonable.
They both have a point, but I'm wondering why a Sega Hard girl would bring up something so touchy.
What do you mean?
Yeah, what do you mean?
You guys were always too ahead of your time in both hardware ability and the software you created.
What's that bike talking about?
Don't mind her. She just rambles on about the stupidest things.
What? All the fans agree with me. For example, Iffy, don't you know? At the end of my era, a bunch of, suggestive titles were being released on home consoles.
You can't talk about the future!
I wanna know more.
Hey, you're supposed to be asleep. You can't just jump into conversations when you're sleeping.
Well, it seems like you have no intention of listening to any of what I have to say anyway. I suppose I'll call it a day for now.
Hey, wait!
I'll come back soon. We will have our final showdown. I can assure you of that. And if you girls are going to side with her, I'll have no choice. You will not have my mercy on that fateful day.
Wait! We're not done talking yet! Okay, that's enough. Iffy, let me go! What's the point of letting this get heated right now?
All the while, this one over here is lost in her happy dream.
We still have time to kill her.
Perverted little goddess. stop making that stupid face while you sleep. This is all your fault.
Why am I getting yelled at?
Because you're the worst character.
Glutie, you kind of asked for it.
Asked for it? Oh, you weren't satisfied with my service? Maybe one more time will do it.
Oh, fuck yourself.
Let me just transform and...
No, please, no, stop! We don't need that! We've had plenty!
Oh, Boo.
You know, Victory would have been a significantly better game if just around the time you recruit Blanc or Vert, one of them just beats the ever-loving shit out of Plutia, and she decides to never be an asshole to her friends again. Because she repeatedly ruins that game. And Neptune's pretty bad in that game in general, too. But they're just complete assholes to their friends for no reason. And no one really... She never suffers for it. And she really deserves... And it would make a lot of sense for either Vert or Blanc to just beat the shit out of her and for her to just never attack anyone that isn't an enemy again. And it would have really helped that game a lot. And it's kind of ridiculous to see her be doing this in this game. Regarding the sadism, I really don't know... I don't know if, there's a reason the Mega Drive is considered sadist. Like, I think it might have just been, like, a random thing they decided, you know, to make her interesting. But, I do remember finding Genesis games a lot harder, because a lot of Genesis games did not save. And most Nintendo games, Super Nintendo games I had, did. But, I'm pretty sure the only reference to difficulty in terms of, like, sadism stuff would be... Not even sadism, but... I'm pretty sure Nintendo Hard is why, like, Blanc is really mean or, like, gets angry. Because, you know, the NES was sort of the crazy hard console. Regarding the whole CG thing, people call CG... people say CGs when there's, like, still images of stuff. Like, everything is CG, but computer-generated. But people tend to say, call it a game CGs. Like, I bet, let me Google Neptunia game CGs. And it's a bunch of images. Here we go. So yeah, when you Google Neptunia game CGs, like, this is just what people, this is what they're called. Make this an image, blah, blah, come on, OBS. OBS, please. No? What is your problem, OBS? You were working... This worked yesterday. Why doesn't it work now? This just worked. Mouse. Ugh. What? What is OBS's problem today? Yeah, when you search Neptunia game CG, where the fuck? No. What do you mean? Where's the capture that I just took? Oh, I put it on the desktop. Duh. This is what people mean when they say CGs. You know, the still images of crap. Like Plutia and Neptune here. That's what everyone means when they say CG. How far down was the bondage scene from Neptune 1? It's apparently here, I guess. I actually didn't play Neptunia 1 still. But I figured that one from Mark 2 would be in there. I swear drag and drop used to just work just fine on... What the hell? It's working now! It worked for that. Why does it work now? It wasn't working just now. Oddlaw is very angry about this. What? I don't understand. Whatever, let's get rid of those. Anyway.
If that happens, I'll let you take care of it on your own.
Oh, you goddesses are so selfish.
It's not like Neptune has literally helped at all, ever, in this entire game. She's really just the bike. She doesn't do anything. I mean, she's helped as much as the bike would have, that's about it. It's a cliff in Panique Cave that you get past. That's odd. I'm pretty sure there should be a bridge there. And now the bridge is probably there. It's like being stuck at home and playing a game with a friend from far away. I guess that does sound kind of unrealistic, doesn't it? Sigh. Suddenly, Panique Cave has changed. Oddlaw is that yellow guy that was on screen. Be fun if the bike could fight. I mean, theoretically, but the bike is also Neptune. One Neptune is more Neptune than is necessary. We really don't need a second game where there's two Neptunes. I think that might be the one I'm missing in the Japanese one. I don't think I ever got that frickin' thing to appear. And yeah, Oddlaw is just Waldo backwards. You might have a different name in Europe, because I think Waldo is something different. Yeah, he's Wally in Europe. Cassettes are dangerous! Okay. Here's Flan. Have you heard rumors about Panique Cave? You can see a sunrise even though it's underground. That can't be real. I don't know what it actually is. Underworld sun has been obtained. What? Now I have to go back there. Mystery about an item found in Panique Cave.
Okay. Let's decide on this place.
Let's take yet another look. Not sure what it means. Might be a boss. There's some optional super bosses that unlock. I think they're required for some quests that are like post game basically.
It's my turn.
But I'm not sure if that's what this is or not. I got that at the same time as this. So I'm not sure if it's here, but I can't believe there's more and less annoying jump sounds for the non-running jump. Because you're always going to be running. Hidden baseballs are so boring to get. I like getting the baseballs. I like, you know, it's just enough collecting to not, that's not like super annoying in my opinion. Oh, is it lagging even more? God damn it. No, it's, I don't know what happened, but something screwed up my internet, and yeah, I'm gonna stop streaming here in a bit. And I'm streaming at like a fraction of my usual bitrate. And that's why it looks worse. I'll upload my local copy for this stream, so it won't look quite as bad.
Jump! Yep. Yep.
Oh, those Samsung things are still exploding? Yeah. I don't know why people buy Samsung phones anyway. They're really expensive, and they do Android so poorly. I wish Google would do more to market the Nexus stuff to like mass market stuff, because it's just way better than pretty much everything out on the market. I don't get what this thing is referring to. I don't see any sun. Like, usually those are hints for like the baseballs or a boss. Unless it's in a different era. Or, oh, it's probably a quest, actually. Let me see. Actually, if it's a quest, it might not show up in my list because I'm so late along the timeline. Oh, hello. You have an event now?
Teehee, I'm X.
Am I still dropping frames? Alright, I'm gonna read this and then I'm gonna stop, I guess. Oh, you're a cute fairy too, huh?
Of course.
Wait, do you know another fairy that's cuter than me? Yeah, you know Hiswar, right? He's got wings and is fairy-like, too. That's not funny. Don't put me on the same level as Hissy Fit. That is that Hissy Fit? How dare you? Hissy Fit, I know she's a little testy, but that's because of Nep. Wait, that means you must be doing something to piss her off. What? It was just a harmless prank. A prank? Yeah, I secretly missed popping candy into her cake. I also put some soda water into her coffee. How terrible. Also, why does Hissy need coffee? Ugh, she doesn't get in my jokes. Pranks aren't jokes! I'm sorry, but pranks are not jokes. It's just being an asshole. Well, maybe if you try to put a prank that isn't going to put her, the people in her mouth. So, like, drawing mustaches on important people in the history books? Teehee. I wouldn't try your luck. Someone's gonna get erased from history. The only good thing at Samsung is its SSDs. Yeah, I would agree with that. Their SSDs are good. I can't think of another product from Samsung that I would recommend, frankly. Let's see this event too, I guess. Place your money here. You can put as much as you want. Okay. I think that's a arcade machine then, I guess? But yeah, I guess I have to yell at my stupid, terrible ISP. If you have any choice to not get Mediacom internet, don't. They suck and I hate them. But yeah, that was fun aside from the stupid internet issues, and I'll upload a higher quality version so you won't have to deal with the crap, all that, you know, compression artifact garbage. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll be streaming Yumi Nikki in another 2.5 hours, I guess, or no, 3.5 hours. So that's gonna be really fun. Yumi Nikki is like this really great, surreal, weird game. Wait, Beam Chat is lagging because of the... Ugh. There's nothing I can really do about that right now. Why wouldn't somebody who constantly overworks herself like Histy need coffee? Well, she's super tiny for one thing. Like, I guess she could make very tiny coffees. But, like, I wouldn't think, like, a supernatural being would need coffee, personally. And yeah, tea does sound more like her deal. Yeah, I'll do some more. I'll try to show only the story stuff on stream, basically. I'll try to do some, like, I'll catch up on the side quests and stuff on my own, and then probably just one or two more streams of this, and I'll be done. I wasn't initially planning to show all of it on stream, but I guess it wouldn't be too hard. And how far are we in? I think this game is about 20 hours, so yeah. Makes some sense. There's a couple of hours on that that are just idle. Boys Mark III Magician? I don't know. I'm sure it's some reference to something, but I don't really know the Sega stuff. I can't believe Sick isn't showing up for any of these streams. Sick the Hedgehog, a friend of mine's this, he's a Mega Drive homebrew developer and just knows all of the Sega things, and he's never here. If you mess up a book, I think Hedgehog would send you to Jurassic. Yeah, I would not recommend messing with books when his drawer is around. Oh, he has observation level 14. That's not bad. Can I buy any new? I think those are the ones I bought already. Yeah, I'm gonna take it down for now and yell at my terrible internet service provider. And hopefully Yumi Nikki will not have as many issues, but I don't know. This is an HughesNet. We actually use HughesNet at work, and we have lots of problems with them. We actually have only HughesNet and Mediacom are the two at work, and I don't deal with them, fortunately. But our network guy is on the phone with them pretty often, which is not really a good thing, obviously. But yeah, yeah, I'll see you guys in a few hours if you want to watch the next thingerdinger.